Now we will see the 8086 DAC interface programming. We will not see the hardware details, but we will just see the programming aspect. First we will see what is DAC. DAC, it is digital to analog converter. So the input to the DAC is a binary count value displayed in binary number, and the output is an analog value. So based on the input number, we will get a corresponding analog output. Generally, the microprocessor or microcontroller does the processing in digital format. So if you want to control a analog value, then DAC comes into. The DAC can be unipolar or bipolar. In which case, if the DAC is unipolar, the output analog voltage will range from 0 volt to the positive voltage. If it is going to be bipolar DAC, the output analog value will have values from the negative voltage to the positive voltage. So further, for this case, we will consider only the unipolar DAC and not the bipolar DAC. If it is going to be bipolar DAC, the values, the count will be different for different voltages. So consider a 5 volt DAC. For considering a 1 bit DAC, if you give the input as 0, output will be 0 volts, analog value. If you give the input as value 1, the output will be 5 volts for a single bit DAC. So in the case of 2 bit DAC, we will have 4 levels. So level 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 0, 0, 1. 0.1. So we'll have 0 volts, 1.61 volts, 3.33 volts and 5 volts. So if it is going to be 4 bit DAC, we will have 16 levels from level 0 to level 15. So the number of levels is decided by the n bit DAC. So if it is going to be 4 bit, it is going to be 2 power n, which is 2 power 4, 16 levels. In the case of 8 bit DAC, we will have 256 levels, level 0 to level 255. Corresponding to input value 0000, 0002, 8 ones for the analog value 0 to 5 volts. Next, if you want to go for I/O interfacing, so the interfacing is done between the microprocessor or the microcontroller. So the I/O devices get to exchange information with the microprocessor or microcontroller through ports, and these ports are assigned port addresses. So if you want to get information from the I/O device, if it is going to be I/O mapped, then we use the IN instruction to give the data from the processor or controller to the I/O device. We use OUT instructions. So next we will see the program for square wave generation. Square wave is nothing but alternating wave between 0 and a higher voltage value. So we will take a case of 0 to 5 volts. The first set of instructions, it's start. So, we assume initially is the AL register to be 00, and that is written to the C8 port address through OUT instruction. And that value is retained for a specific duration. The call delay, this instruction calls the subroutine delay, which is used to provide some delay to the microprocessor. So, after this, a 0 is written till the delay is completed, the same value is retained. Afterwards, we write the value of FF corresponding to 8 ones for the level 255 into the AL register. That value is sent to the DAC through the port address C8. Again, the same delay is called upon. So, from 0 volts, it moves to 5 volts for the value FF, and it is maintained for a delay. Then, again, this needs to be restarted. So, again, value of 00 FF. So same thing repeats. So next we will see what this delay subroutine does. The delay subroutine nothing but it initializes the CX register with a count, and it is decremented until it becomes 0. So it is nothing but counting a big value from, say, for example, if you have 15, 14, 13, 12 up to 1, we count. Similarly, the microprocessor counts from a bigger value to 0. After counting to 0, it returns back to the instruction after the call instruction. So after returning from here, it will go to the this. So after returning from this subroutine, it will go to the jump start. So this count amount in section should be a very high value, not a very low value, because if it is going to be very low value, it will the delay will not be executed, because microprocessor execution will be faster than the I/O device. The value of count is going to determine the time duration of the delay. If the count is high, then the delay will be more. If the count is less, the delay will be less. The count is the one ultimately determining the frequency of the square wave generated. So this will be the output square wave generated for this program. Next we will see triangular wave generation. Triangular wave is going to be from low to high and from high to low on a slow basis. So now during this instruction execution, we assume a register PL with initialized to 00. That will be copied to AL. Through AL, it is written to the DAC through out instruction. So 0 will be written, then the value of BL will be incremented, and if it is not 0, again that will be moved to AL. Through AL, it will be output to C8. So DAC will be written 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 255. After 255, what happens is the BL, after incrementing, it overflows and it will become 00. So that is where this jump on no 0 comes into play. After 255, it becomes 0, and then it comes out of this loop to the next instruction. So after this set of instructions, the corresponding analog output will be 0 to 5 volts. Next, again it should start from 5 volts. So for the corresponding digital count is FF, all ones, 1111, 1111. This will be moved to AL and this will be returned to the DAC through the port address C8. Then next value will be FE. So for that it will be decremented. So it should be decremented until becomes until it is not 0. So when it becomes 0, again it will come out. So as long as it is non-zero, it will be decremented and the corresponding output waveform will be like this. After this, again the program needs to start again from 0 to 5 volts. So after jump start, it will again go